Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. So in this video we will discuss three more properties or three more theorems in Boolean algebra. Okay, if you are first time to my channel, please consider subscribing and hit the bell icon to get video notifications from my channel. So Boolean algebra, already I have discussed some basic laws and De Morgan's theorem in my previous video. Okay, so now we'll discuss three more important theorems regarding Boolean algebra. So in that, first is duality theorem. Okay, so in that, first theorem is duality theorem. So duality theorem states that starting with a Boolean expression, okay, starting with a Boolean expression, we can derive another Boolean relation. Okay, so we can derive another Boolean relation by changing first R to AND, right? So this double implies, right? So double arrow represents R is changed to AND 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 is changed to R. So wherever you have R, you have to change it to AND, and wherever you have AND, you have to change it to R. Okay, so R is replaced with AND 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 is replaced with R. Second, 0 is replaced with 1 and 1 is replaced with 0. So wherever you find 0, you have to replace it with 1, and wherever you find 1, you have to replace it with 0. Okay, so this is about duality theorem. So it states that starting with a Boolean expression, you can derive another Boolean expression. Okay, this Boolean relation is also a valid Boolean expression, that is, it can be proved, right? So it is a valid Boolean expression by changing R to AND 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 to R, 0 to 1 and 1 to 0. Okay, suppose take an example of A plus A bar is equal to 1. Okay, so this is the Boolean expression we know, right? So if you want to find the dual of this expression, right? So if you want to find the dual of this expression, so here there is R, right? Plus operation represents R gate. Okay, so here R represents plus operation and represents into operation, multiplication operation. Okay, so there is R operation. So A, it is changed to AND. A into A bar. So literals must not be any, there should not be any change with respect to literals. Okay, so literals A as it is I have written, A bar also as it is I have written. So wherever there is R here, that is plus operation is there, I have converted it to AND, that is multiplication operation. So AND 1 is also converted into 0, 1 to 0 and 0 to 1. So this is also valid or not? A into A bar is equal to 0. So this is also a valid relation. Just now we have seen in the Boolean laws in my previous video. So A into A bar is also equal to 0. So this is also a valid, and this is the dual of this expression. Okay. Similarly, if you have A plus A bar B. So we have seen A plus A bar B is equal to A plus B. Right, in my previous video I have proved this also, A plus A bar B is equal to A plus B. So if you want to find the dual of this expression, okay, so this is the Boolean expression which you are considering, and if you want to find the dual of this, so what you will write? A as it is we have to write, because we should not change anything with respect to literal, into, because there is plus here, so into A bar. So these two are ANDed, right? So these two are going to be multiplied. So A bar into B. So when there is into, you have to convert that into plus. Understood? So this plus is converted into, and this into is converted into plus. That is changing R to AND, AND to R. Okay. So this should be equal to AB. This should be equal to AB. Is it equal to AB or not? So if you distributive law, by using distributive law, A into B plus C is equal to AB plus AC. So A into A bar, A into A bar plus A into B. So A into A bar is 0. 0 plus AB, 0 plus AB is also equal to AB only. So this is also a valid relationship. And this is the dual of the given relationship. Okay, so this is how the duality theorem works. So starting with a Boolean expression, you can derive another expression by changing R to and to R. So if you are asked to find the dual, just change R to and to R, 0 to 1 and 1 to 0. Okay. So next is consensus theorem. Consensus theorem. Okay, so this states that if the A, B, C are three literals, okay, so if AB plus A bar C plus BC is equal to AB plus A bar C, AB plus A bar C. So that means if A is present, okay, so A is present with B, okay, so A is present with B and complement with respect to C, and there is another term which constitute of these two terms, that is BC, so that will be eliminated and that is equal to AB plus A bar C. So you can eliminate this term, right? So if you want proof, you can also prove this. AB plus A bar C plus, so here I can write it as A plus A bar into BC, because A plus A bar is equal to 1, so 1 into BC is also equal to BC only. Okay, in the place of BC I'm writing 1 into BC, so 1 into BC can be written as A plus A bar into BC. Okay, so this will be AB plus A bar C plus ABC plus A bar BC. Okay, so from first and third terms, okay, so AB plus ABC, I'm writing one side, so next is A bar C plus A bar BC, I'm writing the other side. So take AB common from this, so you'll get 1 plus C, plus A bar C common from this, so you'll get 1 plus B. So 1 plus C is equal to 1, and 1 plus B is also equal to 1, so it will be AB plus A bar C. Okay, so this is about consensus theorem. So you can write duality also, dual of consensus theorem. Okay, so dual of consensus theorem also be represented, right? So how to write this? A plus B, right? So this is ANDed, okay, A and B are ANDed here, so it is ORed enough, right? So it is ORed in between, so in between now it is ANDed. So A bar plus C into B plus C. So here multiplication, here addition. So there each term is added, each term is multiplied here. Okay, so that represents duality. So is equal to A plus B into A bar plus C. Okay, so this is about consensus theorem and its dual. Okay, so next the last law of Boolean algebra is Shannon's law. Okay, Shannon's law. So Shannon's law, Shannon's law is used to find complement of a function f. Okay, so complement of function f. So steps involved in finding the complement, that is using Shannon's law, is, so only two steps are there. First step, find dual. Okay, so find dual of f Okay, so for the given function, you just find the dual. And second, complement all variables. Complement all variables to obtain complement of function f. Complement of function f. Okay, so very simple two steps. So first find dual of this and complement all variables, so in order to get the complement of the function f. Okay, so for example, if you take De Morgan's law, a b c whole bar, right, is equal to a bar plus b bar plus c bar. So we know this, right? Okay, so you can take anything, a plus b plus c whole bar is equal to a bar, b bar, c bar. You can take anything, okay? So first of all, I'll take this. So now the function, I'm taking it as a, b, c. When function is a, b, c, then we can find the complement of it. So complement of it, so f bar is this one, right? F bar is equal to this. When f is equal to a, b, c, then f bar is equal to a bar plus b bar plus c bar. Understood? So abc is the function f I'm taking, so bar over it, that is f bar is equal to this. So we are getting the same or not by using Shannon's law, we'll see. So first of all, you have to find the dual of it. Dual means changing r to and to r. So abc are ANDed here, right? So all three are ANDed. So finding dual, you'll get a plus b plus c. And complement all variables. So complement all variables, a bar plus b bar plus c bar. This is your f bar. Yes or no? Same. Similarly, if you have f is equal to a plus b plus c, the function a plus b plus c. Okay, so complement it, find the dual, all are added here. So we have to multiply in order to obtain the dual, r to and to r. And complement each literal, so a bar, b bar, c bar. This is your f bar. Same we have got. Okay, Shannon's law is also used to find the complement of the function only, okay, but in a different manner. Suppose if you are given with f is equal to ab plus bc plus ca. This is one of the competitive exam previous question, okay. So if f is equal to AB plus BC plus CA, then what is F bar? Then what is F bar? Okay, so he has given many options. Okay, so options are not required. We'll solve this. So first step is to find the dual. Okay, so first step is to find the dual. So f bar is equal to, I'll write the complete question, f bar is equal to a bar b bar plus b bar c bar plus c bar a bar. Yes or no? Yes or no question, right? By seeing, if you take f is equal to this, so generally what we'll do, f bar is equal to, so we'll write it as b whole bar ab plus bc plus ca. Okay, again De Morgan's law, so it will be AB whole bar, yes or no, AB whole bar BC whole bar into CA whole bar. Okay, so again it will be A bar plus B bar plus C bar plus A bar. Right, so by Shannon's law also you'll get like this only. So if you find the dual of this, so if this is your f, what is dual? Dual is a plus b, b plus c, c plus a only, right? So dual of this is this. So AND gate here, OR gate here, so plus there, so it is multiplied. Now complement all literals, so a bar plus b bar plus c bar plus a bar. Same you have got. Okay, so you can use any law. Using Shannon's law also you'll get the same thing, or using De Morgan's law also you'll get the same thing. So apply De Morgan's law here. So you're treating this as A, this as B, this as C. A plus B plus C whole bar is equal to A bar, B bar, C bar. And again individually De Morgan's law, AB bar, AB whole bar is equal to A bar plus B bar, BC whole bar is equal to B bar plus C bar, CA whole bar is equal to C bar plus A bar. Okay, so you can use any law, you'll get the same result. So if you multiply these two terms, A bar into B bar, so first two terms, plus A bar into C bar plus B bar, right, B bar into B bar, so A into A is equal to A, idempotent law. So from that, B bar into B bar is equal to B bar only, plus B bar C bar into C bar plus A bar. So from these two, we know that A plus so if you take B bar common, so A plus AB, if A plus AB is there, so A into 1 plus B is equal to A. Similarly here, if you take B bar common, so you'll get 1 plus C bar, 1 plus C bar is equal to 1 only, 1 plus C is equal to 1, or 1 plus C bar is also equal to 1. Anything, any literal here multi added to 1, its value is equal to 1 only. So this becomes A bar B bar plus A bar C bar plus B bar, right, into C bar plus A bar, again B bar plus B bar A bar. So from these two terms, if you take B bar common, it will be 1 plus A bar, 1 plus A bar is equal to 1, so we'll get B bar only, B bar plus A bar C bar into C bar plus A bar. Now multiply B bar C bar first term plus A bar B bar second term. So here A bar C bar into C bar, so C bar into C bar is C bar only, so A bar C bar I'm writing, plus A bar C bar into A bar is A bar C bar only. Again A plus A is equal to A. Okay, similarly A bar plus A bar C bar plus A bar C bar is equal to A bar C bar only. One time you will get A plus A is equal to A. So what can we write? A bar B bar, so I'm writing first this term, plus B bar C bar plus C bar A bar, right? So it is S. Okay, so this is how we can find the complement of the given function using Shannon's law, or you can also use De Morgan's law. Okay.